For years, Mini has dominated the small, cute market with its Cooper. But from Italy comes a new competitor by way of the 2012 Fiat 500. Some of you might remember way back when Fiat had their little Cinquecento running around the streets, but now they're back with a slightly bigger, updated version for the 21st century. The classic Fiat had the engine way in the back, but for 2012, things were up front where you're used to them. There's not a lot of room under the hood, but Fiat's crammed a 1.4-liter multi-air inline four-cylinder engine. It's good for 101 horsepower and 98 pound-feet of torque. We're looking at a pretty small car here, but thankfully Fiat left us some room in the back. You got room for a bag of golf clubs or some groceries, and if you need more than that, you can always fold these seats down. The inside of the 2012 Fiat 500 isn't a bad place if you're up front. I'm 6'3 and I fit okay, though my ego's a little cramped. The back seat, however, don't even try it. Fiat's gone all out on the inside of the 2012 500. From the gorgeous dark leather contrasted nicely by the dark orange, you've also got Bluetooth connectivity, an iPod jack in the glove box, and a fun interior to look at while you're driving down the road. The 2012 Fiat 500 doesn't do anything extraordinary well, but it's loads of fun. It gets 27 miles per gallon in the city, 34 on the highway, and it's only gonna cost you about $20,000. We're already seeing plenty of these 2012 Fiat 500s out running on the road. Initially, when Fiat left this country, they left because they had reliability issues. But now they're back in a big way, and we think they're here to stay.